Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to show you how to find samples so that you can make a sample beat. And this process is called e-digging. Okay, it's electronic digging. Now the practice of digging the crates or digging for records was basically going into record stores that sold vinyl, and you would search out for records that you could sample. And now with modern technology, the way that people have uploaded samples to the internet, basically, with high quality, you can now e-dig and find basically the same records you would find in a record store. Now there's some qualities of vinyl that some people like, and if you want to stack up your vinyl collection, by all means, go and get the vinyls after you preview these songs, or go support the record after you preview the songs. I'm not going to tell you how to get sampled. I mean, I'm not going to tell you how to treat a sample, but what you want to keep in mind is when you sample, that from the latest controversy of Pharrell and the Marvin Gaye case and Blurred Lines and Robin Thicke as well, you want to make sure, even if you're making a song that isn't from the record exactly, but you took the idea directly from the record, which is a lot of hip hop in the 2000s and the 90s, they may not have taken the actual record and sampled it, but they may have played the exact same way in the exact same style and taken the same, the melody and the chords and everything else. And basically, that's the same thing as taken straight from the record. So you want to be sure you clear your samples if you're going to be using samples in that regard. And also, I think there was a case with 50 Cent being sued by somebody for his mixtape. I forget who it was. Not the Ohio Players, but the Persuaders or something like that sued him for sampling their song. And basically, they didn't see any royalties from it, even though it was a free mixtape that 50 Cent gave away online. But what 50 Cent gained in that case is more fans from doing that. So that's the value that they see, more than just did he sell the record. They see the value behind it. So let's go over some sites and places where you can find samples to ultimately expand your sample library. And again, what you can do with samples is not only just take it and put it in a record. You could replay the sample with your own instruments. You could learn different playing techniques from the samples. You can make a song way more hype with samples sometimes. You can make soulful records, everything else with samples. It can get pretty in-depth. But if you're worried about equity and your publishing percentage, you really want to stay away from samples. But here's for those who love samples and want to find them. Okay, so the first site you really want to get used to is whosampled.com, because I get questions all the time. Can you make a video on how so-and-so made that so-and-so beat? Okay, let's say Kendrick Lamar made his King Kunta beat, okay? Now, on this website, what I usually do is search into Google, and it pulls up who sampled, and it tells me exactly who sampled what in the song. So let's say we go to Kendrick Lamar's King Kunta at whosampled.com. Not only does it tell us where the sample appeared, but it shows us who the artist is, tells us when it was released, and it also, down here, if it has more than just this sample in it that's identified and, recorded, it'll show you down here that, all tracks that are also sampled in this song, and it'll have, a list of songs that are also sampled within this song. But it's only one song in this case that was sampled, and you can click play and it shows you the start time, so you can hear where that sample is heard and how they flipped it in the original song. And you can kind of compare the two and see how you can get that same sound if that's what you're going for. Now, a lot of people who are trying to achieve the hip hop sound for a lot of records is that they don't have the same samples. A lot of the stuff is just getting the right sample, and you're going to sound the exact same way. And it's about finding those instruments that are in the samples or records that are similar to those samples. So let's say you want to find the sample for Truffle Butter, for instance. This led me into a whole rabbit hole of a new fan base on SoundCloud. I found a producer who I like now through this sample reference. So checking samples not only will lead you to what happened in the past, but also what's happening in the future. And that's really cool. Or what's happening that you're not aware of, I should say, not the future. So again, this sample is at 132. You click in, you hear the melody of Truffle Butter, and you're like, wow, the vocal part is like right there. But the difference is, for Truffle Butter, you hear that the sample is less music. There's less music in the background. And what they can do is, they could sample this record, but they might buy the masters of this record. Now, here's the difference between just sampling the record versus going to the record label and saying, can we get your masters, and doing a whole different level of sampling. And that's because they can get the acapellas, they can get the music tracks, they can get every individual track. So there's no music behind the vocals, for instance, when they get that acapella or whatever the case may be. And the record label can buy the master or the use of the master from the record label, and they can sample it into their beat. And that's how the pros get those really in-depth samples that aren't the same as the original record, because they get those individual wave tracks or whatever the recording tracks were. Now, also to keep in mind, you can, like I said, you can also record similar to the sample. So they could have another artist come in and record a part that sounds similar to the original sample. It's not the same thing, but it's similar, but it's still considered sampling because they're copying something out of the original song. So that's what we're talking about when you get musicians to replay a part of a song, for instance, or whatever the case may be. Okay, and you can see all the other stuff. Sample chain found, song sampled in. You know, you can see a whole bunch of stuff. Sample chain, that means they sampled a song and they sampled another song. So it can get deep. And this site really has those in-depth links that help you find those top records and who sampled what. So that's what this website's all about. Now, if you're looking for e-digging as far as random stuff goes, I suggest The Vinyl Frontier. Okay, probably the number one sample blog. I haven't found any other ones except hiphopisred.com, but they have more sample sets than sample digging. This is more of a sample dig site. And this site posts albums and stuff that you probably never heard of. And that's the beauty of it, because a lot of samples come from foreign records that you've just never heard of or never would have guessed to grab. And the uploader or the blog owner or whatever has an extensive history and understanding of samples and even a collection of their own that they upload to the blog. So you can see here, you can go through records that you just never heard of, like Rock Rabbit, never heard of them. I didn't grow up in the 70s or 80s. You can see Shiva, 20 Minute Workout. You can even find music libraries on here, like for networks, like NFL Library. A lot of stuff that they post to this blog. So it can open your mind, and you also get the YouTube preview, so you can hear the sample before you even go to research the sample itself. And that's invaluable when you're searching for samples, because you just want to get a vibe from a certain album to know what it's all about. So that's what this website's all about, The Vinyl Frontier. Here's the official website up top. We'll probably leave a link below in the description, so just keep that in mind. You know, this is how you find samples that you're not, you know, aware of. Another site where you can find samples that you're not aware of is called Dusty Shelf. It has a weird URL, but it's called the Dusty Shelf. So we'll put these links in the link below, in the description below. But anyway, you know, 70s and 80s records. So you see stuff you just never would have heard of. You know, media music, music libraries. Sometimes it's just synth stuff, synth samples. So you can find a lot of stuff from these blogs, from the bloggers who post the stuff, who know more about the stuff. And you'll gain a better history of where music came from and why we lost some feeling in the music and where that kind of sound went. And this is how you're going to generate your own sound, of course, by flipping samples if you start out just by sampling and adding your own instrumentation. Now, another site, which is great, is called hiphopisred.com. Okay, so now at hiphopisred.com, you could scroll through and see their posts. It's kind of like a blog. Well, it is a blog. And basically, you have two different sections. You have the main page here, which is the direct website. You can see they have, if you scroll down, they have reviews, they have special mixtape downloads, they have exclusive downloads, all the stuff over here to the right. They have sample downloads, of course, which I'm going to get to next. So if we scroll down, you'll see samples of the year 2014. So this is a big sample set that they do every year for hip hop. So the samples used in hip hop for the year 2014, for example, they have the year 2013 to 2012, 2011. If you scroll down on the right side, you'll see over here samples of the year 2008, samples of the year 2009, 2010, 11, 12. And they did it since 2008. So that's their trend, and that's what they're probably known for. I mean, that's really cool, because now you get to understand where the samples came from for some of the hottest records in hip hop, and who uses what, and what record it came from, and which records are similar, and everything else. So I suggest getting those samples of the year sets. And also you could check the samples tab there. and it pulls up old albums from 2000. Well, here's the list of 2000 through 2013 of sample sets. Then you have Digging in the Crate with your favorite producers, and then you have artists' album downloads. Now, some of these links don't work, so you got to keep that in mind, but you can go through different artists and find the samples that they used in their album. So that's an extensive history brought to you by hiphopisred.com, another great service for finding samples. Now, that's more targeted to who you know versus the people I don't know, which is Dusty Shep. Not people I know, I mean albums you're not aware of, versus knowing the artist and finding the record they use. So those are two different ways to sample search. Let's get into YouTube. Now, a quicker way I like to search on YouTube, since it has the best related video type of algorithm, what I like to do is type in an old artist, like let's just say Chaka Khan. Okay, so you type in a Chaka Khan video. Now I'm gonna click a video, but I'm gonna mute it right away so I don't get the video flagged for copyright. Okay, so we have Chaka Khan, and what you can do now is either use the song directly or whatever, or you can go on the side where it says related songs, and this is how it leads you to a rabbit hole of just related stuff, and it's just super dope, super cool. And you could check out the side and you know, figure out like Diana Ross. From there, it leads you to another list of people. Let's go here, and then from this video leads you to another list. So you can constantly go on a rabbit hole of just finding samples. And all you have to do is just go to add to and add it to a playlist of samples that you find on your YouTube account. And you could go through and add these songs to your sample list and then, you know, figure out how, if you want to use them or not in your song. That's another way to sample. So that was song sample sites. Here's musicmix.co, which I just found for some reggae acapellas. So you can use this site for dance hall acapellas. You know, I'm not familiar with the site too much, but I use it for acapellas, or I just used it for acapella. So you could use the site. And you can also use Acapellas for You, which is what I used to use before, acapellasforyou.co.uk. And they have tons of acapellas here. We're talking about top 40 stuff to like reggae. So it's all over the place. And you want to register and figure out how to use the site. And all you want to do is use their search function, or you can get their newsletter, which has a list of the new acapellas they release every week or so. And you can go in and find the acapella for some of the hottest songs. Now, the thing is, some acapellas aren't the highest quality. So when it says DIY, that means do it yourself. And that's probably going to have lower quality than studio quality. So you want to make sure you get a high quality if you're looking for acapellas. So that those are, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4... 7 ways, lucky number 7, 7 ways to e-dig, and I'll probably rename the video to 7 ways to e-dig. So thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com, and have fun finding those samples, because it can be fun when you get into sampling. But remember, if you want equity in publishing in your song, you want to stick away from samples, but just consider sampling, okay? Because that's what hip-hop was created on. So, and also be sure that you, or keep in mind that you're going to have to clear samples eventually. So that's going to take away from, again, your earnings. So thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.